Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and this is my video response to the video How Nintendo Can Save the Wii U, which was made by farmhousemedia3000. And I honestly don't know, you know, your real first name, so I don't know how to address you at this point. I've recently discovered your YouTube channel, so this is one of the very first videos of yours that I've watched. And I've definitely really enjoyed this video. I think you make a lot of great points, and it's an interesting video. Now, I just want to respond to your video by just adding a little bit of, I think, are important points to consider, more points to consider when talking about Nintendo and Wii U. So, the first thing you mentioned was the virtual console, so that's what I'll start with. Virtual console on the Wii U is a pretty tricky thing to consider. On the one hand, you're totally right. There should be more virtual console games, more of them released, faster releases, and GameCube games as virtual console games on the Wii U would be awesome, would be amazing. Why aren't they happening is the question. And that, I found some answers when I was reading some articles like 2 weeks ago. And the articles seem to suggest that there is much more technological and licensing barriers when making a game, a virtual console game for the Wii U. And this barrier is so much more different and tougher than it would be for Nintendo releasing a virtual console game on the DS, 3DS, or the Wii. Therefore, we can only expect from now on that Nintendo releasing virtual console games on the Wii U will be even more slower, will be even more problematic than it was on the Wii, DS, or the 3DS. So, all the articles I've read regarding the Wii U and the virtual console were very pessimistic. But I think that's a realistic thing to expect. I think it's wishful thinking right now to hope that Nintendo releases a bunch of virtual console games. I think it'd be great. But at the same time, even if they do everything perfect with virtual console games, at the end of the day, they are just rehashes and re-releases. Sorry, that word just totally. Yeah, so it's not going to appeal to an entirely new crowd, and it's definitely not a reason to get you to buy the Wii U. So ultimately, it's there for the fans, what you suggest, but it's not really going to do anything console selling wise, you know. But I think those are really great ideas. My personal really big gripe with the way Nintendo handles virtual console is, you know, now we look at things, there are four devices. There's the Wii, there's the DS and all the iterations of the DS, there's the 3DS and all the iterations of the 3DS, and then there's the Wii U. Let's say I buy Super Mario World virtual console game for the Wii. I have to rebuy that if I want to play it on the DS. I have to rebuy that if I want to play it on the 3DS. And I have to rebuy that if I want to play it on the Wii U. The digital software is not transferable to different devices based on the same account with Nintendo devices. That's a huge problem because this isn't the case when we're talking about the competitor devices. My iPhone, you know, has transferable abilities with my MacBook. And iPods and such of the nature. When I buy a game on Steam, you know, it's locked onto my account. When I buy a game on the PlayStation Network, it's locked onto my account. And I can, there's even like, you know, a cross purchase for PS3 and PS Vita. So when you're comparing Nintendo's way of doing virtual console releases with other competitors' devices, it's just really problematic. And so even if, you know, they release, I don't know, that's just one big hurdle of Nintendo to overcome, I think. I don't know how they'll do it, but that's one issue they really need to address in the future. The second thing, and I guess this is probably the most important thing for Wii U right now, is software drought. Where are the games, you know? And I think there are many factors to this, all of which makes sense, but it's really unfortunate for Nintendo that this is the case. I think Nintendo, you know, made a statement saying they're understaffed with this first-party development. And they had to, like, transfer some staff onto work to this game, finish this part, and then have that staff work on this other game. So that's why there are so many delays, and so, you know, the development is hard going. I guess I can attribute this, I think, to the fact that this is now Nintendo working on HD. This is, I don't think they're doing really well with the transition stage. So that must be part of it. This is the first time they're actually making HD games, and none of the Nintendo games so far that were released have been actual HD games. Like, you know, Super Mario Brothers Wii U is a 2D game. Mario Kart Wii U is kind of 3D, but it's not necessarily like a super intensive graphics wise. So graphically, I think Nintendo is struggling with technology, and the fact that there's and the way they're managed is also a problem. The biggest problem with software drought, I think, is its relationship with third-party developers. For example, if Microsoft had the same exact issue as Nintendo, saying, oh my gosh, you know, our first-party development teams are understaffed, Microsoft would not be having a problem because they have so many third-party developers making games for Xbox 360 and also probably for the next Xbox. It wouldn't be a problem at all. There would be no software drought if that was the issue with Microsoft. But the fact with Nintendo is it doesn't have like a great relationship with third-party developers. It's actually starting to, you know, for EA, for example, you know, is completely becoming like, you know, there's like an animosity between EA and Nintendo right now, which is really weird. So instead of developing more third-party support, Nintendo seems to be losing third-party support. It's even Ubisoft has historically always been the most supportive of Nintendo's systems. But even now, Ubisoft doesn't seem to be, that support from Ubisoft seems to be fading. This is a huge problem, meaning there will be less games for Nintendo. Nintendo will really have to rely on its first-party development, but that development seems to be, you know, mired with issues and issues. So, again, really pessimistic here, but that seems to be the reality of the case. I would say that, you know, making more games would be great for them, but, you know, and the last thing is, of course, the marketing, which has just been really poor from Nintendo. One thing I want to mention, and this is the obvious thing that everyone's mentioning, but it's right. The name Wii U is just a horrible blunder by Nintendo. Naming it the Wii U was one of the worst mistakes I've ever done with this console. If they named it Wii 2, that would have meant, you know, this Nintendo would have been in such a better position than it is now. They could still change the name. I doubt they'll ever do that because it's, you know, no console has ever just changed its name in the middle of its, you know, release cycle. But that's one of the biggest blunder there, the name itself. Not a lot of people know that there's a console out there. The fact that Nintendo had to send a message out to all the Wiis saying that there's a Wii U out is just ridiculous. I think it's a great strategy, but it should have been done way, way earlier if that was a strategy they were going to utilize, because currently a lot of Wiis are collecting dust. The fact that you sent a message out means that you're assuming that people have their Wiis plugged in and turned on. A lot of people don't. So you sent that message out, a lot of people are not even going to know that you sent a message because the Wii is not plugged on. It's a huge problem. So that's one of the things. Now, I've been really pessimistic about Nintendo right now, but I would like to end it on a positive note, saying that the good thing about Nintendo is that all of this doesn't really matter. I mean, you know, this right now it's going to be... It's not going to be likely. It's going to be very, very improbable that the Wii U is going to sell as much as Wii U or even come half as close to that. It's probably not going to happen. It's not going to be this massive sales success story that the Wii was in terms of hardware. Software attachment rate for the Wii is a different story. But in terms of hardware sold, yeah, it's not going to happen. But the good thing about Nintendo, the good thing they could look forward to is the fact that Nintendo games are unlike any other games, and Nintendo fans know that. So when Nintendo does release its first-party games, it's always going to have its fans buying the Wii U just for the Nintendo games. So it's going to have a good solid fan base that it can always rely on. And that's I guess the thing that Nintendo kind of will save them in the end. And they have a ton of cash in, you know, in their account because of that fact. So I think they can survive through this Wii U 3DS generation completely fine, even if they totally screw everything up. I think they can survive fine. It's really unfortunate that, you know, Nintendo made these horrible mistakes and blunders, and, you know, they're not going to be number one anymore. And once this fall happens and PS4 is released and the next Xbox is released, you know, the Wii U is going to be obsolete and irrelevant to the gaming landscapes. And that's the thing that Nintendo really has to worry about, I think. And I think, you know, the faster they think about coming up with the new console after Wii U, the better it is right now. Because I don't really think Wii U stands a chance at this point, as great of a console as it is. Cheers.